Ben ik geier. So die chassidische Verbrengenischen in 717, nachten bei Nacht. Druckt nimmer viel.
Yeah, bin ich geier to the forcing people to adopt certain religious standards of tznius. These are religious standards. They're not secular standards, which are, you know, like different things that are not inappropriate and offensive. So when it came to doing that, the claim, it's very sad that Moti Gradi, who I spoke to by the Shiva, explained to him how, unfortunately, he wasted his life in religion when he could have lived a better life. He dedicated his life to nonsense. He understood, like, he understands it. He knows it now. I don't know why he's being cruel. But the Rebbetzin worked very hard, Rebbetzin Chaim Musia, not to give in to any religious standards of tznius. You can see these photos are printed in the Allgemeine Journal of her by a party. She has a cut dress, goes past her upper midsection, of course in literal terms for Yeshiva Bachrim, past the breasts. But in what was fashionable then, she went by secular standards of modesty and appropriate behavior, social obligations. But no, she never accepted any religious coercion, and she paid a heavy price for it. You can see she wasn't present, she wasn't able to walk freely on Kingston Avenue. I don't know how it worked out, these details you could always ask Chaim Baruch and other people who were working in Beis Arav, but she paid a heavy price and it's very inconvenient to not be able to sit in by different things, different chassidish gatherings and stuff like that, because she would not give in, because she knew that if I give in to tznius, how is that going to help the poor and the broken heart and the little guy? How is that going to help the next butchering of society? So she did everything she could that we should not be able to force religious laws of tznius, which is all of it came from Avodah Zarah, from the church, and mixed with the romantic ideas. None of it comes from Torah, none of it comes from Yiddishkeit. And cruelty is cruelty, so strip it apart like a simple Kantian philosopher. You have it simple, you have it's not complicated. It's very sad that people fall in, maybe Mati because he had a keri on Yom Kippur, and other things because he travels and he's nichshol a lot in Bias Asuris because he's a seicher, and he travels and he thinks it's not going to be an aveda, so he takes out his anger just like the Arabs do in the shooting up the clubs. The night before they did Kol Davar Aser, and they go thinking that they're going to pay God back by getting God's enemies. God doesn't need you to get his enemies. He needs you to deal with your tivus, and if you can't deal with it, don't take it out on innocent people, especially mothers, akedas abayas. Their tznius and their lack of tznius is kodesh kadashim. Don't fuck with it. Listen, just like all these street preachers and the anti-gays, we find out that they were stooping boys in a hotel room. Mirz Hashem, very soon the word's going to get out and everyone's going to know that Afringanov brent the Hitl. And this is a message that we're begging the strong to have rachmanis, and we're begging the weak to stand up. Hopefully you'll meet somewhere in between. Thank you for watching Sheni v'Chamishi.